Welcome to Utawarerumono, Mask of Deception, episode 47. Pretty sure it's 47. No, actually, it's not 47, it's 48.
Yeah.
48 episodes, soon hit 50, and I just... I don't know if I say it like a lot of times now, but I so love this series. Love this game. Alright, so, what's up next? Well, I kind of feel like the kitchen should be somewhat short, and the entrance may also be somewhat short, so maybe we can take these two, and if they're too short, we'll take and start the guard post, but yeah. So let's do the kitchen first, because it sounds like that would be the most fun. It would get, yeah, munch munch. Everyone is sharing in a freshly made batch of ruru. So it's, I guess they call it that because it's... Rurute made it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Ruru has getting a reputation as the Hakurokaku's signature sweet. Oh, people come just to ask for the recipe. Oh yeah, right, that's the recipe that they did. As a result, we've been seeing it sold in tea houses around the capital more and more. Shouldn't you have taken paid for that? Like, yeah, you can have it, buy the recipe here. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, but you want any meat? Rurutea prefers a jug of milk, an essential part of drinking tea in Yamato. I'll take the jug and pour a helping into my tea. In the end, yeah. I can see the Rurutea in my hand. I keep wondering, Yeah, burning everything, yeah. Yeah, but it just took too long, Okay. Well, no, At the least words, however, a flash of inspiration strikes me. Recognition sparks in Rute's eyes. She seems to understand even before I finish explaining. Yes! She was actually allowed to. Kind of flavor to add, yeah. I glanced toward Rurutea, thinking carefully. Rurutea fidgets as my eyes fall on her, flustered. Mm-hmm. Lute notes and retrieves the jug quickly. Okay. Lute follows my instructions and pours slowly, stirring in the milk while heating it. Okay. Everyone crowds around to watch her experiment, intrigued. The resulting new mixture begins to bubble and boil softly. Yeah. Oh, ah. Impatient, Kuan steps forward and dips a finger into the boiling pot. What is that? Unperturbed and unburnt? Unburnt, Kuan scoops up a fingerful of mix like it's nothing. She licks her finger clean without as much as hesitating. Really? As we follow suit, dipping her finger, wincing a little at the heat, and sampling the mixture, alright? Whoa! Holy shit, what was that sound? She proceeds to sigh every last drop from her finger, okay? At the turn comes reaction, Nekone and Rute steps forward. Oh, yeah. That looks so good, yeah. Oh, as Nekone nurses her burned hand, Kuan offers her freshly redipped finger. Wow. Nekone blushes fiercely, but obediently eases off Kuan's finger. Oh. Yeah. Atui playfully dips her finger again, mimicking Kuan, and bring it to my mouth. Oh. No matter what I say, oh, yeah. I steal myself in need of Azui's outstretched finger. Right? Alright, I have a feeling that something is not gonna be. Okay. Okay. Condensed. Zuite looks at me puzzled. Maybe it's an unfamiliar term. Mysterious name for a mysterious flavor, yeah? Yeah, that's good, yeah. With that, I reach for the pot to take some more of the condensed, but... Zuite seems to notice me hesitating in front of the pot and blushes. Making up her mind, she holds out her hand to me. If you'd like, huh? I felt flattered for just a moment, but decided to accept her offer and eat. What is this event? What is this event? I take a glance to the side as I eat from Rute's hands. Everyone else in the room is looking at us. Oh boy. Okay, I pretend not to notice. That's a good way. Several days later. Right? Okay. Genius though you may be with. Yeah. The right man for the right job, indeed. Nekone-san's exasperated with me, but her mood seems to recover quickly. Yay! Nekone happily opens the door as she says this, full of anticipation to find. Okay. Hi? Okay. Angie paces back and forth, exciting greedily from a small jar in her arms. Nekone immediately pounces on the jar, trying to wrest it away from Anju. Your hospitality. They shout without listening to a word the other has to say, tugging on the jar. It's gonna. The jar flies free of Anju's grasp and tips, spilling his content all over both of them. Yeah, I tried to warn you. I'm glad we don't get a CG of that. Kuon arrives to find the mess, laughing to herself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What? Kuon's been baking you for herself, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, as Kuon takes in the scene of the fight, her eyes settle on Anju, covered in condom. Yeah. Kuon grins, pleased with herself, just as she had after we created the first batch of voodoo. Doesn't look like there's going to be an end to this chaos anytime soon. No, it's not going to be an end to it. Alright, so that didn't take that long. Let's take the entrance, and then we'll take the guard post. But I don't think we will be able to take the guard post in this video, but yeah. So let's see what the entrance has to offer. Alright. I return from patrol duty to find a drained, despair-filled Kiryu standing guard at the inn room. Welcome back. Kiryu forces a smile, eyes lifeless and haggard. Judith smiles back, but backs up a few steps after seeing his expression. What is the Well, Swan. Oh, hell. Twitch. Hi. Kiryu knows, shivering like some kind of newborn animal. Okay. Okay, in order me to send. Whoa. Sorry for bumping the mic. Huh. He's here again. I rub my temples to dispel a brewing headache. Hey! I open the door. There lies Anju, snacking and reading on the couch as always. And I really don't want to hear her laughing like that, yep. Oh, no. Upon seeing Anju, she turns as pale as Kiryu and begins to fidget. Harder, oh yeah. Haven't we had this event already? She kicks her legs idly as she leases. No princess should be saying, yeah. How bizarre, the proud elegant princess Kuon and I saw on the day of the native festival. Yeah. Reduced to this. How the mighty have fallen. Embarrassed, yeah. But... Besides being Kiryu hunches over in shame and pain, clutching his stomach. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Kuon arrives and takes one look at the messy room. Oh, your highness. Nekone arrives behind Kuon, a furrow in her brow at the state of the room. Hey! I can feel Kuon and Nekone's eyes on me like daggers in my skin. With your puppy dog. Okay. Okay, Briar's. Okay. Yeah, there's Lily. Okay. Oh, yeah, right, yeah. Bad details, yeah. Eat your vegetables, eating too much bad. Holy shit. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well. If you desire a reward, okay. Once more she produces that fine gold necklace of studded with you. Guess it can't be helped. Could you? Yeah, we have had this event once before, but it turned out a little different afterwards because she just took it and kind of rushed away. And now she hid it again. It's nothing. Yeah. I'm pretty sure we've had this kind of event, yeah. His bargain, okay?
Yeah.
I decided not to hold my tongue, a little irritated at taking orders from this brat. But as I said, I'm pretty sure we had this event like one of the first times she came here. It's just that she hid, yeah. Because it felt like it was reusing the same text. And that's the thing. Bloodline, my body, yeah. To doubt her, yeah. Comprehend, yeah. I could probably cut the tension in the air with a knife right now. Kuon's smiling, but I can see her eye twitching and neck and lips are shut tighter than a vault. I'm gonna go get the... Rute seems to sense it too and finds a reason to excuse herself. Thank you. She never gets better. Yeah. Oh boy. Right? Voice. Hey, it was us in the corridor. Yep. We turn to find a woman approaching us. Her gaze is cool and collected, and though she's shorter than me, she feels as though she's looming. She's like a quietly towering mountain. And you guessed it, yeah? I'm looking for someone named Haku. Oh. That'd be me, yeah? And carries an immense presence. Even shake your hand, miss. Never mind. Munechika offers his hand to the test, smiling politely. Clearly, still a little hesitant, the test shakes her hand. She's someone. Is she someone famous? The person is currently taking refuge in this Hakuroka cave. As it takes her off. I found a please excuse me. Anju immediately freezes in place. Though that slovenly smile remains plastered on her face, she begins to sweat profoundly. She slowly shifts her head to look at us. That's the scream. The next moment, she scrambles into the nearest corner in the room and crowds in covers in fear. Your Highness. Okay, fulfilling his... Is that okay? I can all but feel everyone else in the room sharing the same thought. This girl is hopeless. Yeah. Unperturbed by Andrew's auxiliary, Munechika muses quietly to herself. Okay. As you go. Okay. Oh. It was. Okay. For the teaching. Munechika sizes on his mid sentence and puts the girl firmly over her knee. Oh. Is it? Yeah. What the f? What kind of slap was that? Kiryu's expression is pure anguish and despair. Nikone seems emotionless at first glance, but the corners of her mouth are definitely raised. It serves you right, yeah. And for some reason, Kuan is whinging, looking on with a grimace of unexpected sympathy. The fur on the tail stands on an end as she watches Anju's fate. Yeah. Probably not something entirely appropriate to ask right now.
Indeed.
Indeed. Oh. Okay. Azui throws open the door with the worst possible timing, freezes at the threshold. And tea for Ebo. Lurita returning from the kitchen also freezes in place when she sees what's transpiring. This is just farcical now. We've treated the princess pretty poorly, sure, but this is on a whole other level. My stomach. Wow. Yeah. So, okay. Wow. Damn. And you raise on the ground nearby for you to be curling up in temporary defeat. And you glares reapproaching at us as he says this. Okay. Yeah. You will, okay. She continues to glare at us, hot tears in her eyes, alright? Yeah. Give you sensitive stomach. Oh. Automobile controls on music. Stocked with literature, yeah.
It's dull.
Indeed, kind of true. But yeah, still a kind of locked place, I guess. That swish. Without a word, Munechika raises her hand threateningly. Anju dives under a blanket and begins to shake. Yeah, chill down my spine. You did right in doing so. Kuan seems to feel sorry for Anju somehow and accepts it. Yeah, well, kind of true. Tell her. Little, I suppose, yeah. And you look secure with watery eyes. Yay!
Yeah.
No one.
really?
Yeah. It might be that it reminds her of her mother or like one of their sisters. A princess? Kyo smiles pleasantly, reaching towards Anyu with one hand. She squeezes on his cheek and begins pulling. Alright. How dare you? Anyu reaches for Kyo's face and pinches her cheek in turn. Nice there. Munechika wraps her chin, watching the two of them struggle. Rurite offers Munechika the tray she's still carrying. Good girl, Rurite, even amidst this chaos, she remains polite and hospitable in the storm. Take it all, because the girls have been more mental for you than guys, I guess. Munechika accepts a cup, then lifts a community from the tray and takes a small bite. In that instant, her eyes snap wide and she looks down, yeah. Alright, so I don't know how long this event will be, but we are reaching like the episode limit. So I will end it here. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and until next time, be cool.